الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
Welcome dear brothers, dear sisters, tonight inshallah this special event about inshallah الحجامة, the sunnah way of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and الرقية الشرعية also. The Sunnah way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have our guest tonight at the Islamic Center of Rasida, Sister Abira Khan. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalam, welcome inshallah. And let me inshallah in the beginning just to cover this subject inshallah from some dalil from the Quran and from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of the الرقية الشرعية and what's the proofs of that and also الحجامة, what is the proof of الحجامة in the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. الرقية الشرعية, the meaning of الرقية, when somebody said رقية, يا شيخ I need رقية, it's not رقية, it is رقية. رقية means to ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى the help. You are in problem, trouble, hardship, and you asking for ruqya. Ruqya means you ask Allah for help. Istiaadha, the way you say a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. I seek refuge in Allah from the shaytan, from the evil of so and so and so and so. For ruqya, actually it is not the sheikh, it is not the somebody else, no, the ruqya it is Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah the one who gives shifa. Allah the one, he said the Holy Quran, wa idha maridtu fahuwa yashfin. If I get sick, Allah the one who gives me shifa. But إحنا we are أسباب, we are أسباب. فالرقية means some آيات from the Holy Quran or دعاءز from السنة النبوية, the دعاءز of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. You read it for the one who is sick and وتنفث على موضع الألم where the person is complaining or the sick person, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى he's the one who gives شفاء. القرآن الكريم, I said that too many times, it's a miracle. Each Nabi and every Nabi, when he came with miracle. And when he died, he, his miracle gone with him. Except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He came with too many miracles, and the best miracle, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with the Holy Quran. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died, but still we have the Quran. Al-Quran al-Kareem, it's a treasure. And for Muslims, we have to understand the value of the Holy Quran. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. I have sent some ayat from the Quran. Actually, the Quran, it's all shifa. It's all shifa. رَحْمَةٌ مَا هُوَ شِفَاء. Shifa for what? For somebody already sick. الشيخ make دعاء for شفاء. Okay, means what? He already sick. فالقرآن it's a cure for that شفاء. What is the meaning of رحمة? الشيخ شعراوي said رحمة means protection. If somebody is not sick, the Quran it's a protection for him. يبقى شفاء for somebody already sick, it's a cure. ورحمة means protection. And Allah said in different ayah, قل هو للذين آمنوا. القرآن say this Quran for the مؤمنين, the believers, the believing men and women. He said what? قل هو الذين آمنوا هدى, guidance, هدى, هدى means guidance, وشفاء, شفاء, cure. Another ayah said ويشفي صدور قوم مؤمنين. القرآن is curing the chest, the heart of the مؤمنين. فالقرآن الكريم in general is a شفاء. رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم he made رقية for himself every night. Before he used to sleep, alayhi salatu wasalam, he used to collect his hands like this, easy, and he used to read قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ three times, وَيَنْفُثْ without saliva, three times. And he used to wipe his body. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقْ three times, he read it, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقْ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ three times. And he used to wipe his body, alayhi salatu wasalam. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, he read it three times and he used to yanfuth And he used to wipe his body, his chest, and his back, and his head. And he used to sleep, alayhi salatu wasalam. Every night he used to do that. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created too many things we don't know, we are not aware about it. Jinn and too many things around us. We don't know anything about it. It's unseen for us. But we have the key. What is the key? To protect yourself, make this ruqya. Rasulullah used to make it himself. وكان صلى الله عليه وسلم يتعوذ من الجان وعين الإنس حتى نزلت المعوذات. صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to seek refuge in Allah from the jinn and the evil eye. Evil eye, so my experience, I tell you, the most and the worst thing can harm the human being, the evil eye. Not the jinn. The jinn also, evil eye has a shaitan, but also it's the worst thing. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, most of the diseases and even death of my ummah because of the evil eye. Somebody die with cancer, somebody die with disease, somebody die with this. People, they mention the disease, they never mention the eye. But in reality, behind all of this, the evil eye. Evil eye can make somebody sick. In the end, he will go to his grave. Rasulullah said that. إِنَّ الْعَيْنَ حَقٌّ, the eye is true. وَإِنَّ الْعَيْنَ لَتُدْخِلُ الرَّجُلَ الْقَبْرَ وَالْجَمَلَ الْقِدْرِ, the evil eye can cause a man to be in his grave and the camel to be slaughtered. Subhanallah. Arab people, they were very famous in this. They used to see somebody is coming with his caravan, they used to hire that one with the evil eye. Just give him one. That's it. Done. خلاص. Subhanallah. Yes. Nowadays, people, they are in doubt about the evil eye. Ya ragil, it is in the Quran. وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدٍ أَمْ يَحْسُدُونَ النَّاسَ عَلَى مَا أَتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. Quran said that. How can you deny this? Subhanallah. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to seek refuge from the jinn and the evil eye until Allah sent المعوذات to him. قُلْ عَوْذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ وَالْعَوْذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. He used to read it صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَكَانَ يَرْقِ بَعْضَ أَهْلِهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم. He used to make ruqya for his family. What he used to say? اللهم رب الناس. What is the pain? He used to put his hand above the pain, headache, pain in the part of the body. Huh? And he used to say, اللهم رب الناس أذهب الباس واشفي أنت الشافي لا شفاء إلا شفاؤك شفاء لا يغادر سقما. See? فالشفاء from Allah. Again, الرقية means I'm asking شفاء يا الله from you. It's not from the Sheikh, from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وكان صلى الله عليه وسلم يعوذ الحسن والحسين, his grandson, الحسن and الحسين. He used to make ruqya for them and he used to say, your father Ibrahim عليه السلام, he used to make تعويذ or ruqya for Ishmael and Isaac with these kalimat. What is the kalimat? He used to read this. اللهم, يعني Prophet Ibrahim made it for Ismail, Ishaq, his sons, and Rasulullah made it for his sons, grandsons, الحسن والحسين. اللهم أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من كل شيطان وهامة ومن كل عين لامة. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة. What is كلمات الله التامة؟ ما شاء الله, his names and we don't know it. من كل شيطان, from each and every شيطان. من كل شيطان وهامة, هام الهوام, anything walking on earth we did not see it. Scorpion, snake, jinn, whatever, هوام الذي يهيم في الأرض. ومن كل عين لامة, from the evil eye. See, evil eye, everything. Rasulullah used to seek refuge in Allah from that. He used to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protection for that. جبريل عليه السلام, when Rasulullah was sick, لبيد بن الأعصم, Jewish, he asked his daughters, they take some of the hair of Rasulullah sallam and they make magic, jadu, for Rasulullah. فرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, they make سحر التخييل. What is سحر التخييل? رسول الله used to imagine that he made intercourse with his wives, but he did not. See? Why? Because of this magic. And when the رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم was complaining from that, Angel Gabriel عليه السلام came and he made ruqya for رسول الله. What did he say? بسم الله أرقيك والله يشفيك من كل شيء يؤذيك من شر كل نفس أو عين حاسد الله يشفيك بسم الله أرقيك. He said it three times. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما شاء الله. And he said Ali and العباس or سيدنا علي, they get دجادو from a well, one of the wells of Medina. They found it in a mud, like henna, you know. They found this magic or this jadu. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw in the house of his wife, Umm Salama, a little girl. في وجهها سفعة. سفعة means صفرة. She was like sick. Her face was yellowish, more yellowish. يعني very sick, dying, like she's very sick. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, استرقوا لها فإن بها النظرة. Make ruqya for this girl because she get evil eye. النظرة means she get nazar. She get nazar, the evil eye, see? فرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم he used to make ruqya and he made ruqya. Jibreel made ruqya for him. He made it for Al-Hassan Al-Hussein and he used to ask ruqya for somebody sick like this little girl. And nowadays يقول لك يا أخي بلا ruqya. أنت سيبك من التخريف ده. يقول لك تخريف هذا عمل لك كده. يقول لك what is fake هذا؟ What is this? يا أمي سنة رسول الله. What are you talking about? Wait, listen. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم لعثمان بن العاص الثقفي, if you are complaining from any pain in your body, I'm not telling you don't go to medical doctor. Go to the medical doctor. But also make this with yaqeen, certainty, Allah give you shifa, inshallah. Maybe Allah will give you shifa before you go to the doctor. Subhanallah. Look, Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم was telling عثمان بن العاص الثقفي, if you have pain, when he came to رسول الله, I have pain in my hand, in my arm, in my head, whatever. I have pain. He said, put your hand above the pain. What is the pain? And say Bismillah 3 times. Do you know what's the meaning of Bismillah? There is no harm with the name of Allah. The dua said, Bismillah الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. With the name of Allah, there is no harm. Huh? I have pain, for example, my arm here. This pain is here. I make like this. Bismillah. Bismillah. Bismillah 3 times. And what else? Say 7 times, after that, 7 times in the same pain, same place. A'udhu, I say it slowly, عشان تبقوا مرايزين. A'udhu بعزة الله وقدرته من شر ما أجد وأحاذر. This is one. You take your hand away and put it again. A'udhu بعزة الله وقدرته من شر ما أجد وأحاذر. 2. A'udhu بعزة الله وقدرته من شر ما أجد وأحاذر. 3. Count 7. That's it. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, he told the صحابة do this. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم, when they asked him, يا رسول الله, can we make ruqya? He said, ما أرى بها بأسا. What's wrong with it? It's good. Do it. You ask help from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, من استطاع منكم أن ينفع أخاه فليفعل. If anyone of you can help his brother or sister, do it. This kind of help, do it. فليفعل, let him do it, why not? صلى الله عليه وسلم. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم one time was praying and the scorpion bites him, عليه الصلاة والسلام. And he said, لعن الله العقرب, may Allah curse العقرب. The Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم is not leaving anybody, those who are praying or those who are not. And what did he do, صلى الله عليه وسلم? He called them to bring water and salt. And he mix it and he put it above what the aqrab bites him. And he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, he read, قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد. And he read المعوذات. قل عوذ رب الفلق وعوذ رب الناس. Where is that? The scorpion bites him, عليه الصلاة والسلام. And also there is a hadith of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. That man, big one man, he been beaten by a scorpion or a snake. And he was reading Surah Al-Fatiha. And he being cured. And he said, Ya Aba Sa'id, Rasul, oh Aba Sa'id, how did you know it is ruqya? Fatih said, yes, Ya Rasulullah, I just read it. I just read it. See, we have all of these treasures, shifa in the Quran, and we don't know about it. And you like the ruqya, akhi, you can make ruqya for yourself overnight. There are too many millions of ruqyas in YouTube. Why you cannot turn it on and listen to the ruqya before you sleep overnight? You don't need any sheikh, you don't need anybody, just put it in your house. Surah Al-Baqarah, Rasulullah said, Surah Al-Baqarah, تمحو البطلة ولا تستطيعها السحرة. There is no sahir, magician, or jadu can defeat Surah Al-Baqarah. Ayat Al-Kursi, you read it every night, the greatest verse in the Holy Quran. You read it before you sleep every night, there is no shaitan. Angel will guard you until second day in the morning. The last 2 ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah, Aman al-Rasul, the same. It will, you will be satisfied. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said كفتاه you will be satisfied when you read these two ayat صلى الله عليه وسلم. الشروط الراقي, the one who makes ruqya for you, you have to know he has some conditions. Not anybody can come and make ruqya like this. Somebody must be qualified, he knows the Quran, the Sunnah, the Deen, scholar, plus he must follow the Sunnah way when he make the ruqya, and he must be expert. Why? Because might be you bring somebody to read for you and jinn will come and he gonna put you in trouble, you and him. I know too many things. Jinn tricky, you know, and jinn they are lying. First of all, al-raqi he must have wudu before ruqya. Both of you, the one who need ruqya and the raqi, the one who's making ruqya, wudu. They turn their face toward the qibla. Also, al-qira'a jahran, the raqi must recite loudly. If you see somebody talking secretly, tamaim like this, this is magician. Especially if he asks you about your mother's name and all of that stuff. You know, if he sees him, he's talking to himself like this, means he's saying, he's calling jinn. Jinn, they are coming to him. The raqi, nothing hidden. Just read the Quran al-Kareem loudly, like the one I'm talking to you right now. And the raqi, he must put his hand where is the pain for the people, subhanallah. And also, if you make ruqya, don't make it one time and two times and that's it. No, make it continuously until you will be cured, until you will get shifa 100%. You go to the medical doctor, you're like, if he gives you an antibiotic, like, you have to take the antibiotic until the last dose, right? Ruqya, you have to take it until the last dose. You know, as a Muslim, you have to listen to it every night anyway. You don't need it if you have to be sick. Yeah, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when people been talking about ruqya, he said, اعرضوا علي رقاكم, show me your ruqyas, and there is no problem with the ruqya if it has no shirk. You make shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why التمائم, you know, people, they get sometimes الخرز الزرع, the blue thing, they hide it and they make blue things like with the hand like this, and all of this is haram. Or they put ta'weez, they hang ta'weez here. This is haram. All this is haram. This is shirk. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, he made dua against those who are hanging this ta'weez. He said, من علق ودعه فلا أودع الله له. Dua against him, Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said. ومن علق تميمة, they call it تميمة, ta'weez, it's called تميمة in Arabic. ومن علق تميمة فلا أتم الله له. May Allah not complete his mission. Rasul said that. Why? Because Allah عز وجل wants you to attach your heart with Allah, not with anybody else, not even with the sheikh. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said about those who are seeking help from the jinn, the magician, they are kuffar. Magician kuffar. They are kafir. And they are doing one of the seven deadly sins. السحر, magic. Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, he talks about that. And the Quran al-Kareem said in Surah al-Jinn, وَأَنَّهُ كَانَ رِجَالٌ مِّنَ الْإِنْسِ يَعُوذُونَ بِرِجَالٍ مِّنَ الْجِنِّ فَزَادُوهُمْ رَهَقًا. Some of the men of ins, human, they ask help from some of the men of jinn. And the men of jinn, they make the human men miserable, their life. If you want to ask for help, ask Allah. If you want to seek help from Allah, that's why you cannot go to this magician or you ask them for help. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you go to this magician, just you don't believe yet, you don't believe, just you ask them a question, 40 days no salah will be accepted from you. What about if you believe in them? You have to make tawbah, you have to take shower and say shahada again. You're kafir. Yes, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. If you go to a magician and you believe in him, and he's gonna benefit you or harm you, you're kafir, you're out of Islam. Go take shower and say, Ashhadu an la Muhammad Rasulullah again, make tawbah. Yes, wallahi Rasul said that. Because the one who can benefit, Allah. The one who can harm, Allah. Allah, the one who can harm you, Allah, the one who can benefit you. Al-Nafi huwa Allah, wa-Dar huwa Allah. That's why Rasulullah said to Abdullah ibn Abbas, Ya ghulam, idha sa'alta, fas'alillah. When you ask, ask Allah. وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. If you seek help, seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From not from anybody except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are too many types of sihr. طبعا, I cannot cover this subject today. I have 37 lectures in English in my YouTube channel about jinn. All types of jinn, how to cure this, and the symptoms, and too many details. Somebody tell me, Sheikh Juma, how do you know this man has jinn? Of course, easy. I look at the symptoms. When you go to the medical doctor, and that medical doctor, he studied, he know the information about his job. You go to him, he asks you, oh, what do you feel? Do you feel pain here? Do you feel anything? And he's asking about the symptoms. For him, the symptoms, he gives the prescription. This is what I'm doing. That's nothing, it's a ilm, it's a knowledge. It's a knowledge, nothing else. There are too many symptoms for each type of sihr, magic, or jinn. We have, for example, this, I count some just to give you يعني, some information, and I don't like to talk too much. I want Sister Abira to get benefit from her tonight, not from me. Okay. There are too many types of sihr. Sihr al-aswad, the black magic, which is the worst. The black magic, the worst. And the red magic, and the white magic. There are too many. Sihr al-mashroob, they make sihr and the drink and the food, and you eat it, that's stuck in your stomach, in your intestines. ممكن, they can stay 20 years, and the jinn can stay in your stomach. That's why when you read Quran, or you drink, or you read the ruqya, you say, oh, start frowning up, and oh, screaming, yelling, and crying. I see, some of them, they faint. Yeah, this is symptoms. Sihr al-najasa, wal-azu billah. This magician, they get the blood from the women period, and they put Quran with it, and they make najasa, impure thing. You know, yeah, they are, it's kufr, all kufr. Sihr al-marshush, they make sihr and they throw it in front of your house or your dukan, your store or something to no rizq anymore. There are too many things. Sihr al-hayawanat, they make sihr with the dog, for example, and they make the person crazy. He's talking to himself in the street. Whenever the dog, or sometimes they put it in the catfish and they throw it in the ocean. Whenever the catfish is running, the person became like crazy, majnoon. Yeah, that's a shaitan. What is a sihr? The magician, he has too many shaitan, they are working for him. For free? No. Why the shaitan working for the magician, from the human being? Because he make qurbani for them. What is their qurbani? He make kufr, he get the Quran and he put it in the najasa, bathroom. He write the Quran upside down. He make kufr, they are kuffar. He make him happy. That's why the king of the jinn, he has too many babbles of this jinn. They are shayateen, too many in the street. He said, okay, you go serve this man. Okay. And this magician, he sent the jinni to that person in wherever on the earth. He sent it to him. Okay. Those who are asking, we need him to be crazy, majnoon, sihr al-tafriq, to separate him with his wife. And this Quran said that. فَيَتَعَلَّمُونَ مِنْهُمَا سُورَةُ الْبَقَرَةِ مِنْهُمَا مَا يُفَرِّقُونَ بِهِ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَزَوْجِهِ. They separate between husband and his wife. You see, subhanAllah, sometimes the husband looking at his wife, oof, like, she's like a monkey. And she look at him like a donkey. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. Why he became like this? You know, they hate each other. Sister Sana'al, she likes it. You know, yes, they hate each other. Yeah, I cannot stand with you. Khalas. Wallah al-Azim. Even their breath. Sometimes the bad smell from their mouth, the bad smell from their body. They take shower. This is still the bad smell. Burping all the time. Gases all the time, a lot of symptoms. Bad dreams, black dog, black cat, black snake. He sees himself is flying, falling down. He's seeing dead people every night. Sometimes you have something called the lover jinn too, sihr al-ashiq. Oof! Allah ya jama'a, wallahi, you don't know. Some calls from Allah, South Africa, from India, they call me in WhatsApp. You see, girl, 22 years, she's suffering from this lover jinn. I said, did you pray? Are you praying? No. What a subhanaka rabb. You're gonna be surprised. Wallahi, there is a lady, she's in 50s in her age. She called me from South Africa. She's accounting. In her work, I'm sorry, jinn is making intercourse with her while she's sitting in her desk. She's suffering. People are suffering. Tayyib, jinn is strong like that? No, jinn, they are not strong. We are stronger than jinn. Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, when he used to walk, jinn used to scare and run away from him. Right? Shaitan. Rasulullah said that. But إحنا, we are the one who, يعني if somebody has a house, right? Sisters, brothers. And that house, before he leave, he opened the doors and the windows and he left his house like that. Don't blame yourself if any thief come and he take everything and leave. إحنا, we are opening our doors and our windows to the shayateen, to jinn. We don't have salah, no salah. We are heedless, no zikr, no Quran, no ibadah, nothing. We are heedless. And Allah said that. وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ نُقَيِّدْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا فَأُولَهُ قَرِيبٌ. If somebody became heedless, he's not remembering Allah, Allah will appoint shaitan. He's gonna be his qareen. He's gonna make his life miserable. That's why, see, Sister Sana, she's gonna tasbih, subhanAllah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah. How shaitan can come and attack her. Never. We are see, Shaitan is coming from here. شايفين؟ فسبحان الله أنت you are physically you have bones, flesh and blood. Physically you have كسافة, you are heavy. شيطان no, they've been created from the flame of the fire. If you walk and you step on شيطان you're gonna kill him. شيطان is very weak. But the problem of شيطان is they see us but we can't see them. This is a problem. And from there they can attack you. Especially if you are غافل, you are heedless. You are away from Allah Azza wa Jal. See? Let me make it short. There are too many sihr, as I said. طبعاً, the symptoms of this sihr, when people ask me, Sheikh, I feel I'm not normal. طيب, how can you know easy the symptoms? I can, from three things, I can know this person has jinn or no. Number one, if I read Quran for him, some ayat, or I ask him to read Quran, he cannot. This is one symptoms. This is the main one. He cannot read the Quran. Number two, if you read the Quran to him, you feel his chest become tight like this. He can't even breathe. He's not normal like that, subhanAllah. Look at him, look at his movement, look at his eyes, look at his face, you know? Especially when you remember Allah or something like that. He's not confident. He's looking around like somebody crazy, insane. Okay, these are some signs I can know from the beginning, since I look at his eyes. طيب, after that, I ask him for too many list of symptoms. I can tell me yes or no. Just don't say anything. I can ask you, say yes or no, yes or no, yes or no, yes or no. From that, I can evaluate it from 1 to 10. This guy, what type of sihr he has, what type of sihr, and how can I cure him, what kind of ruqya is benefiting him. It's all similar, but there are some tricks there, you know, because from your experience you can know. There are too many ways, but it's very easy, it's not difficult. People, they are scaring, no, you don't have to. This is يعني, some of idea of the ruqya al-shar'iyya and why and how people been attacked by shayateen because they are away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How to protect yourself, again, Surah Al-Baqarah, Al-Fatiha, Al-Ma'uzat, Ayat Al-Kursi, last two ayat of Ayat Surah Al-Baqarah. سورة المعارج، سورة الجن، سورة ياسين، سورة دخان، يقول يا أيها الكافرون إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها، سورة الصفات، all of these سور، especially if you don't know any one of them, just put البقرة، خلاص، البقرة is enough for you. Just put it all the time in the house. سورة البقرة، that's it. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said جني and magician, they cannot stand البقرة، that's it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you. There are too many types of raqi and ruqya in the internet. But be careful, brothers and sisters. Don't be deceived by the magician. Because these people, they are claiming they know the Quran, the Sunnah. In reality, they don't know. They can read little ayat, but when you see them blink their lips without talking, they ask you about the name of your mother. Give me something from your clothes, from your picture or sound or anything like this. These people, they are magicians. Be away from them. Be away from these people. Nothing secret. When I make ruqya for people, I talk loudly, openly. I am not hiding anything because ruqya is ruqya. I have to hide means I'm talking to my jinn. They call it tamaim. Before I end, inshallah, al-hijama, which is the cupping sister, Amira Zair, mashallah, she's very expert in that. طبعاً, there are too many dalils from the sunnah of al-hijama, and al-hijama is the best medicine before and after and until the day of judgment. I don't want to go more against anybody, but al-hijama, I see it the best. Who said that? Not me, Rasulullah. Let me mention some hadith. In Sahih al-Bukhari, authentic, very authentic hadith, عن سعيد بن جبير, عن ابن عباس, the cousin of Rasulullah, صلى الله عليه وسلم, قال, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الشفاء, the cure, in three things. الشفاء in three things. Number one, شربة عسل. Honey. Pure honey. Drink it. That's شفاء. Allah said, it's a شفاء even not for the mu'min, for الناس, for everybody. فيه شفاء للناس, everybody. Honey. Number two, شرطة محجن. شرطة محجن means the cupping, the حجامة. المحجن, شرطة محجن. شفاء in it too. Number three, wakayatan binar, with the fire, but I don't like to use the fire because Allah gonna punish the kuffar in the fire. The only one he can punish with the fire, Allah. That's why I don't like it. Rasulullah said that. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, another hadith, inna afdal ma tadawaytum bihi al-hijab. The best, afdal ma, afdal yani af'al tafdil in Arabic. Means the best of the best of the best. The best cure for your shifa, al-hijama, the cupping. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, nothing better than al-hijama. The best, afdal ma tadawaytum. يعني أنا for me, my understanding, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he made الحجامة, the cupping 15 times in his life. Last one he made it, they call it المغيثة, above his head here. When he was eating the poison from the Jewish woman, she feed him poison with the sheep. He made المغيثة. Wait, do you know what's meaning for المغيثة in Arabic? الإغاثة, المغيث. Imagine somebody swimming in the Pacific. In the middle of the Pacific, and he get tired, he cannot swim anymore. And he make like this, help! This is the meaning of Al-Mughith. And one of the names of Allah, Al-Mughith, the one who can help. Khalas, you think you're gonna be destroyed? He said, help, help! This is help, means that this is Al-Mughith. That's it. This is the final. Yes. For Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he made Al-Hijama 15 times. He made it in his leg, between his shoulders. The Al-Mughith here, he did it sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, أفضل ما تداويتم به الحجامة وهو من أمثل أدوائكم الله أكبر. والله العظيم, this hadith is enough. He said, the best of your شفاء الحجامة, and this is one of the best cure, دواء. عليه الصلاة والسلام said that. الحجامة for me, like the vacuum. You need a carpet? It's the vacuum. الحجامة for me, it's a vacuum. I am not a medical doctor. I study medicine in Egypt for years, but I'm not a medical doctor to talk. But from my understanding, I made al-hijama myself since I was 24 in Jordan as an imam. I never stopped making hijama every 6 months. Yes, I never stopped it. Hijama, ya jama'a, it's with this trash food we are eating now, chemical stuff and trash, we are eating trash. There is nothing organic like before. I'm a farmer man. We used to eat from the land with our hand when I was little. Now it's a trash food. I'm sorry, yani. And this, subhanAllah, is going to your body every day and night. You are poisoning yourself every day and night. Subhanallah. I remember that doctor who was teaching me when I was in the college. He's a medical doctor. He used to say, any medicine, it's a poison with little value. Yani they, subhanAllah, it's a poison. When you put medicine in your, this is little poison in your body. But that's why I'm not against anybody, but the point here is the food now became poison. And the Rasul said that in too many ahadith. Al-ma'ida bayt al-da. Al-ma'ida, your stomach, is the house of sickness. We're eating, too much, and this food is not clean. Al-hijama, your body throwing all of this under the skin, all of the trash of the body. Al-hijama is just the vacuum, it's cleaning. Throw it outside, the trash, that's it. This I give it to you easy way. Maybe I'm wrong, I'm correct, Sister Abir, she's going to talk now about it. But the point here is, this is, for me, my understanding. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was in al-Mi'raj, he used to see the Malaika. Whenever he used to pass by a group of Malaika, they used to tell him, Ya Muhammad, oh Muhammad, salamu alaykum, alayka bil-hijama, do hijama, don't miss it. Al-Malaika, this is the best advice to tell Rasulullah when he was in al-Mi'raj. الحجامة يا رسول الله. Do it. And صلى الله عليه وسلم, he made حجامة between his shoulders. The best time for حجامة, Sister Abira, we're telling you now, the day of 17, 19, 21 every month. This is رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, this شفاء from any kind of sickness. And he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, the best of your medicine, الحجامة, and something else, القسط البحري or الهندي.